Good day for everybody. First of all, on behalf of the Peace and Solidarity Organization of Sri Lanka, which is a member organization of World Peace Council, we would like to extend our big thank you for extending their solidarity to our Sri Lankan people by the Liberation Organization, prestigious and important human rights and peace organization in United Kingdom. So to be precise and short, I will use written text when necessary when I am answering your questions. So answering for the first questions of liberation, you had raised that Sri Lanka is going through a deep crisis economically and politically. You had asked how did the country end up in this situation. So I would like to give a comprehensive short answer. Initially, we can identify this as a crisis developed over a period of time. So major historical reasons are neoliberal economic policies, corruption, nepotism, and capitalist rulers entrapping country in debts without effecting utilization of loans. If we look at the debt crisis which we are facing today, within the period of 2010 to 2020, within 10 years' time, foreign debt has been doubled in Sri Lanka. During the years of 2015 to 2019, almost 4.5 years within, foreign debt increased from $23 billion to $39 billion, which that means within 5 years' time, we increased our debt by $16 billion. But Sri Lanka, within the same period, GDP only increased from $79 billion to $84 billion only. But we borrowed $60 billion. So we think that we have been following the policies of neoliberal gurus. So this is what we have gained. And about due to this debt crisis and economic crisis, inflation has increased to around 130%. 130%. For an example, staple food of Sri Lanka is rice. So 1 kilo of rice was in April, it was around 130 rupees. Now it's around 300 Sri Lankan rupees. And one loaf of bread, it was 54 rupees last April. Now it's around 190 rupees. By the end of April, our foreign reserves, we had $5.5 billion. Now we don't have foreign reserves, it's zero level. So in addition to the reasons I mentioned, this recent mismanagement of the crisis, like printing paper money and pumping hard currency to keep the dollar rate fixed, also caused to deepen the crisis. So lack of foreign currency is the reason for limiting importation by the government. So lack of essential goods such as petrol, diesel, LP gas, food items, medicine, people compelled to stay in long queues to get the essentials. So prices of the essentials have risen steeply, as I mentioned earlier, 130% inflation. So Sri Lanka is, I would like to insist this point, Sri Lanka is a textbook example of how a country in the periphery can be destroyed by neoliberal imperialist economic policies without having a war, without having an invasion, without having any natural disaster. Sri Lanka is a country destroyed by following neoliberal economic policies. So these are the major factors for this present economic political crisis of Sri Lanka. Thank you.